You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. From his Central Texas Command Center, deep behind enemy lines, the information war continues. It's Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Richard in California, you're up next. Thanks for holding. Then we'll go to Robert and others. Go ahead.
Hey, Cal. I got a couple questions for you and your whole liberal, namby-pamby, Liam McAdoo formulae, all right? Why do you hate America? And who are you working for?
Oh, you're being sarcastic. Come on.
I love you, Alex. Please, though, just another round of OxyClean. I think you're full of it today.
Okay, so it's easy to have ad hominem attacks. I am a liberal in the Thomas Jefferson sense. I would be called a right-winger today because I'm pro-life, I'm pro-gun, things like that. These labels don't mean anything. I want you to have due process. Hold on a minute. You made some claims there that were just ad hominem attacks. It attacks the entire judicial system and destroys faith in any type of free trial or any testimony if torture is brought in. And so that's why I'm against torture. So argue for torture. Don't call me names.
All I can ask you is this. Where were your tears crying for all those Palestinian people that were getting bombed into oblivion this summer? You didn't have a show for them.
I said that was tribal warfare that globalists have organized, and I think it's bad on both sides, and I think it's overall a manipulation to destabilize the region, and the Arab countries use that as a scapegoat to ignore their own oppression. It becomes the cause celeb because that's all Hollywood promotes. So, again, you just want to attack Alex Jones. You're not defending torture here today, are you?
No, I think it's okay. It's just Arabs anyways, right?
All right, this is a sarcastic. Sir, I was the person day one saying 9/11 was being basically staged to attack Muslim nations and take over. And our government's funding radical Islam to destabilize the whole region. But none of you so-called trendy liberals, and that's why you made that joke calling me a liberal, care about the hundreds of thousands of Christians killed in Syria or just people in general being murdered, mainly blacks, in Libya. I mean, that's just all you need for a moral equivalency and to feel good about yourself is just say I support Israel, but just because I don't hate Israel. I criticize Israel from a place of strength when Israel's wrong. That's why Israel lobby groups like the Southern Poverty Law Center and ADL attack me and why the white supremacists attack me, because all they've got is tribalism. That's all they've got. It's why the black sites, a lot of them call me a racist, because I'm against race war. Or I don't want to have a war with the police because they're being manipulated. So now I'm pro-cop. I'm anti-civil war. Here's the deal. I've already won the fight to prove there's a world government being formed and that tyranny is rising and that big banks run the planet. I don't care who runs them. I'm against a new derivatives bailout. I don't care who's doing it. I want Florida out of my water. I don't care who's behind it. I want the GMOs gone. I've already proven it's going on. I've already won that fight. Now I'm trying to stop the globalists staging a race war and then civil war that I predicted that they're now starting. And you know who's listening? And all you government people and all you dumbed-down, low-information shills that aren't sophisticated, that just feel good and go, Zionist shill, Vatican shill, Reptoid shill, Bill Hicks shill, whatever delusional, weak, loserville stuff you do. I want us to win. I cover real issues that have an effect. And the fact that I don't want protests in America to be go shoot some cop directing traffic, that's a good moral statement that makes sense. And you know what? Instead of just attacking the police, I'm converting them because they were already Americana, and there's already that vein in them. I'm reminding them of what they already were. I'm not even converting them. And the system will probably, there's a good chance, come after me for it. It's a good chance. I don't want to say things that tempt fate. I just, they hate me because I want peace. I want justice. And if you're black or white, I love you. If you're a cop or a firefighter or a school teacher, I love you. I don't care who you are. I just want you to love freedom. I mean, it's best interest for you as well. I just am promoting freedom here. It's like selling snow cones in hell, man. More calls coming up. We'll go to Robert and everybody else. Stay with us. Back in 60 seconds.
The average person's life is filled with unexpected challenges. Unlock the energy it takes to defeat these daily beasts with Super Male or Super Female Vitality, specifically designed to assist the body in regulating proper hormone balance to create superior vitality in males and females. Supercharge and conquer your world at InfoWarsLife.com or call 1-888-253-3139.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel body armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel body armor just won't quit.
KLN, Los Angeles, Clone Radio. We play the songs that sound more like everyone else than anyone else. Clone.
Hitler took the guns. Stalin took the guns. Mao took the guns. Fidel Castro took the guns. Hugo Chavez took the guns. 1776 will commence again if you try to take our firearms. The Republic will rise again when you attempt to take our guns.
I have sworn upon the altar of God eternal hostility against every form of tyranny over the mind of man.
The answer to 1984 is 1776. You're listening to The Alex Jones Show.
Listen up, scumbags. I don't care if you're a grassroots scumbag that likes to rob old ladies and mug people, or you're a big mega banker like George Soros and a known Nazi collaborator that wants to try to overthrow our sovereignty, get rid of our borders, and take our guns. We're not your slaves. We have awoken, and we're going to take this country back. Right now, we're debating torture. Yes, it's like the Ring of Mordor with the new Hobbit movie coming out. You can win any battle with it. But you start torturing, you become the devil. I understand the Machiavellian view, the perspective, I don't agree with it, that end justifies the means. You use dirty tricks, it will consume you. The moral high ground is a harder road, but in the end, it's much more successful. Evil is quick and easy, like Yoda says about Darth Vader. Is the dark side stronger? No, quicker, easier, more seductive. It's absolutely true. This country has all its problems, but it's demonized constantly because compared to all the others, and I've studied the history of the world, it's fascinating. We were the most moral. We were unique. We were trailblazing. We were strong. We were founded by men and women who were so intelligent and so cool that they set about to take the Renaissance to the next level and change the world forever and beat the greatest empire. And they didn't torture people. They did a lot of other evil stuff. But they recognized it and said it was evil and said, we want to change. It's that decision in the heart. King David did horrible things. Sent his best friend off to be killed so he could have his wife. But then he repented and really repented. It's the heart that God judges. And let me tell you, it'll poison our heart torturing people. Yeah, it's a phone book upside the head of a child molester one day to make him confess. The next day, you're raping a child like the Army reports admit they did at Abu Ghraib. We can't sign on to that, ladies and gentlemen. We'll lose our souls. Just like we can't sign on to abortion or any of this garbage. It's immoral. Let's go to Robert, North Dakota. You're on the air. You think torture might be okay? Go ahead.
Hey, Alex, love your show, man, and I love all your products, and I, you know, I agree with you 100% on everything. What I told your call screener was that, you know, I'm a veteran, I'm an old-school veteran, and, you know, I believe in honor, helping the oppressed, dignity, loyalty, You know, I hope there's still some of that left in our military. And I absolutely, those things that you read, I believe are absolutely horrible. But there's two things I want to get out. And one is, you know, we train in the Sears course and stuff like that. We train for waterboarding and sleep deprivation. I don't think those are torture if it gets our information that we need. But the other things that you mentioned are absolutely terrible. Now, where you cited that you read the reports from CNN and ABC and CBS of those horrible things, my question is, I don't trust the mainstream media, especially CNN and all those that you mentioned, because they've been in this administration's back pocket from the get-go.
Yeah.
And they've constantly been demonizing our military, defunding it, spreading it thin, and then deploying us. And so how do we know, I mean, I'm just confused, how do we know that what those reports are saying that they did are true, and not just CNN, ABC, and CBS just fabricating that and making it up?
Well, I mean, here's the thing. I cannot believe the you guys are so sophisticated, especially the veterans, the combat veterans. That's why I hate doing this show sometimes, because I want to explain all the pieces, because if I just explain some, it aids the enemy. There's an internal fight between the NSA, the CIA, and the Army. The Navy's involved. The Air Force hadn't been around that long, so it's not as deep. But the Army usually was the most powerful thing in the U.S. and pretty darn good. I mean, they really, overall, the history of the U.S. Army, because it was founded by George Washington, overall, it's pretty good. And then you get the CIA in 47 and the Air Force in 47 and NASA in 47, all these new groups they tried to set up to move power into those. You got the Navy that used to fight with the Army. You got the Marines, their own group, that aren't too political, generally, I found, when you get into all the intel. But there's blocks in government fighting. And yes, the CIA leaked the torture photos at Army bases to blame the Army, because they're trying to take over the Army and take over the drones. And I mean, I have this, not from me, this is from, like, Colonel Schaefer and Dr. Pachinik and three-star generals I talked to off record. I mean, the government listens. They know who I talk to. So, I mean, I don't know all this stuff. I have a mouthpiece, so, I mean, I have a venue, so I'm told this. And it turns out to be good intel. And then I realize, well, these guys are... I mean, I used to interview Admiral Moore every month. He was the chairman of the Joint Chiefs before he died. And, man, before he died, he was just spilling his guts on everything. He was the chairman of the Joint Chiefs, former judge advocate head general before that. And you're absolutely right. There's inner fights going on. The CIA and the media released that report to burn the Army. So the Army released a report with the full details pointing out the CIA controlled past a certain area. They controlled it. They would pick Army they wanted to be involved. So it was actually a setup to burn the Army, the rape of the kids and stuff. So what you said is super sophisticated and super accurate. You're absolutely right. But how do I explain that to a general audience? I mean, it's so sophisticated. I spend 15 hours a day trying to figure it all out, and I can't figure it out. I mean, what do you say to that?
Well, thank you for clarifying that a little bit, because that makes more sense. I've experienced that infighting myself, so I've seen it, and... that makes more sense. So then the simple truth of the matter is...
Look at how the Army gets blamed for Camp X-Ray.
Yeah.
But who runs the base within it? The CIA. And again, I don't want to just demonize the CIA every time, but so many times they're the ones that it ends up... they're the group that started playing dirty in this country. They're the ones that accepted Machiavelli in 1947. They've been using the Ring of Mordor since day one, and they have screwed this country up. Go ahead, sorry.
Yeah, and they introduced the LSD and all the other stuff.
You name it. It just always leads back to them. It just...
So that makes sense then, Alex. Thank you for clarifying that, because that infighting, so these things, in certain sense, are going on, but so they're using... It's like they're using it to... against each other.
Exactly. Let me explain how this works. My dad working, like, back in the 80s, and I've said my parents did some government stuff, was trying to fight communists, and he had some groups that he knew and family that had worked for the government say, will you help take care of some East Germans and things and try to get them ready to be sent back to Germany? And, I mean, then we had, like, white vans driving around our house when that was going on listening to us, and I was, like, you know, 10 years old. My dad's probably about to start calling up, getting mad at me. But the point is that it's just all it's not. It's, there's like seven CIAs, there's like four or five NSAs. There's only one Marine Corps. There's like two armies. There's three or four navies. I mean, there's all these factions. And the truth is, no one can even figure it out. I mean, this thing is so crazy.